there are many people, those who ask me almost on the daily basis that what is your opinion on Yes Bank? And in few cases I reply and in few cases I don't. But I think let's make another video on Yes Bank. First of all, let me clear one thing, that Yes Bank is a sheer case of persistence and patience. And all those people who do not have persistence as well as patience, I really doubt Yes Bank is a case for them. I have told already that Yes Bank is a clear case of 3 years old patience. It means that you need to wait for 3 years to get some results in Yes Bank, provided that the so-called Indian operators do not play. In this video, I'm going to give you some hints about Yes Bank, and the people with the IQ greater than 8 would able to get that hint, and the people IQ lesser than 8 will not get the hint. Yes Bank case happened somewhere in March 2020. You know, when the mess happened, the Rana Kapoor acknowledges more or less the fraud. The investigative agencies came into the picture and rest all is going on. Yes Bank share tumbled. We came in public domain and we said that Yes Bank is a FD and you need to hold this FD for 3 years. Treasury consulting is also long in Yes Bank and would continue to be long even for 5 years for the following reasons. Number one, if I exclude the other banks of India, which is HDFC, ICICI, Axis, and to an extent SBI, I think there is enough market which is left for Yes Bank to pick up. Because I really don't think that HDFC, ICICI, and Axis, they got the whole market. There is a big set of market which is left to pick, and I think that if we have a right management on the cards for Yes Bank, then we able to pick that market. More importantly, with Yes Bank IPO, which is FPO, follow-on public offer, which is already done, and the main important part, because unfortunately what happened that but media in this country, what media shows, people only see that. And apart from that, people don't see anything. People saw that retail investors not participated to the rightest extent. I agree, but people not saw that QIBs oversubscribed their share. And I'm damn sure that 99% of the people, those who are watching this video, even do not remember the list of the QIBs, which is qualified institutional buyers, those who subscribe the Yes Bank FPO. And guys, by the way, we got 3 Indian banks in the Yes Bank FPO. That's it. It means that an existing Indian bank is taking up a position in the Yes Bank FPO. Now, the people with the IQ greater than 8 understood what I wanted to convey. Another important thing about Yes Bank is that, like Lakshmi Vilas Bank, the private equity player expressed their interest. And I'm sure that the Indian corporate sector is passing from a huge liquidity crisis. There is no doubt about that. In fact, this liquidity crisis will grow on a monthly note. Hardly any day passed when I not got the news of Indian corporate sector who is raising money either by the right issue or by the follow-on public offers or by the offer for sale or via the dollar routes. Because the app was not ready, we were not been able to handle this, but now the app is ready, we are able to handle this. Guys, the story is dollar routes and all these things are having limitations. Indian banks also need huge capital, and this capital can only be provided by the private equity players, because the problem is that as the startups are dying across the globe, the private equity player are left with, which is known as dry powder, and they are having a huge capital and they are looking for sources, and Indian banks need money. So you have two people, Indian banks and you have private equity. They need money and they have money, lest you know. But the moral of the story is that now Moody's upgraded the Yes Bank. And that is, Moody's Investor Services on Monday said that it has upgraded several of the Yes Bank debt instrument to B3 from the CAA following the close of the lender 15,000 crore equity fundraise. The rating agency also upgraded Yes Bank baseline capital adjustment from to CAA2 from CA. Now, with the upgrade of the Moody, the confidence of the private equity players will definitely come. But once again, the Yes Bank is a story of 3 years. And if you're expecting the results from Yes Bank to come in 1 month, then you're wrong. Yes Bank is not that kind of stock. Remember, when Amazon was starting and somebody had took Amazon $10, and today Amazon is around, you know, thousands of dollars in US. How lucky that person is. He got Amazon at throwaway price. But the question is, he hauled the patience to hold Amazon till 2020. Do we have the patience to hold Amazon, to hold Yes Bank 3 years? And more importantly, even 3 years to make our portfolio according to the market requirement. This is our personal recommendation. If somebody copy, this is their problem. All gain and losses would be of that person. I am going to be keeping Yes Bank at least for 4 years because I hold the patience even for 4 years. Have a great time, and I hope that Hindi media must have told you about this. Because in stock market, if you continue to sell, buy, sell on a daily basis, you will not get anything. But if you hold the right stock with the patience for 3 years, in some cases 1 year, and in some cases 2 years, you get. This is my recommendation. And I'm going to be holding for 4 years. This for sure. If you copy this, gain loss would be yours. That is. Have a great time. You know our WhatsApp number.